morning and welcome to this Monday edition of Ram Talk, October 27th. All right, we got some special guests for you. You know it's homecoming week. We got the drum major, Chris Jennings. But before we get to him, we're going to go to the news with Alyson.
All right, thank you, Marissa. And here are your top headline news. In international news, United States Deputy Defense Secretary Paul Wolfowitz barely escaped injury after terrorists fired a barrage at the Al-Rashid Hotel in Baghdad where he was staying. U.S. security is now being scrutinized for its lack of ability in defending this attack on a central Baghdad building. The attack killed an American colonel and wounded 18 people. In national news, wildfires continue to rip through much of Southern California today, destroying more than 800 homes and killing at least 13 people. These wildfires have been the state's deadliest tragedy in 50 years. Authorities say the fire was ignited Saturday when a lost hunter set off a signal fire near the town of Julian. Other major fires were started separately in the San Bernardino County. In local news, a man in connection with the kidnapping of Lawrence Harding was caught by police. Harding was found dead in the trunk of his car on August 26 in Richmond, Virginia. Jeremy Morrell was charged with first-degree kidnapping and armed robbery. Winston-Salem police will not say whether Harding will be charged with murder as of yet. In sports, Winston-Salem State University Rams defeated their biggest rival on Saturday 47-0 against North Carolina Central. This makes the sixth straight time the Rams have beat the Eagles at Bowman Gray Stadium. The game marks the Rams' biggest victory in the 28-game series. Go Rams! And in entertainment news, Scary Movie 3 came out at number one in the weekend box office, bringing in $49.7 million in its first 3 days. Texas Chainsaw Massacre came in at number two with $14.7 million, followed by Radio with $14 million. And now let's take a look at the weather. Expect today showers and overcast with a high of 65 degrees and a low of 45 degrees and 100% chance of rain. On Tuesday, expect partly cloudy skies with a high of 60 and a low of 47 with a 10% chance of rain. And on Wednesday, expect also partly cloudy skies with a high of 68 and a low of 48 degrees with a 10% chance of rain. And that was a look at your headlines for this edition of Ram Talk. I'm going to take it back over to Marissa. Marissa?
It's homecoming, y'all.
Thank you, Alyson, for that news report. And before we get this thing started, I got to sing a little song for you. Y'all ready? Can I get crowd participation? H-O-M-E-C-O-M-I-N-G is homecoming, y'all. Woo-woo! Homecoming, y'all. All right. Thank you. Chris, what's
yes,
up?
Yes, ma'am.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Now, you are the drum major
WSSU
Marching Band.
Yes, I am.
Now, what made you want to try out to be the drum major this year?
Well,
it's your first time, right?
Yes, it's my first time. Well, high school, I didn't have a chance to really, be a drum major. So I wanted to try out. And it was hard learning and adjusting to a new style of marching. So I was just talking to a lot of old heads and just talking, and they was encouraging me, you got what it takes. You know, I had the heart or whatnot and the leadership abilities or whatnot. So, I tried out. Okay. And luckily, I made it. So.
Now, was it hard? What did you have to go through?
It wasn't necessarily hard. It was hard marching during the year because our band director, Mr. Emery Jones, he looked at what you did the whole year as far as marching-wise and like I said, leadership abilities or whatnot. And okay. We did an interview process. He asked us, maybe 6 or 7 questions. Mm-hmm. And so, he picked from those.
Now, tell the people or the students that your classification.
I'm a sophomore.
Sophomore is a drum major, not a senior or junior, sophomore running things,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So how did you enjoy the game, being on TV?
Oh, man, it was so hype. Unluckily, the other drum major, Mario Bird, she wasn't there because he had to be at a military camp, but he came to the game because he left the camp and came to the game.
Okay.
But so I was solo, had to hold it down by myself, but it was so much fun.
Freaking the sticks and everything.
On the dolo. Yeah,
okay.
So it was so much fun. It was hectic because it was so much stuff that you had to do with the time and being on the TV commercials and stuff like that. And then we came down for halftime and whatnot. So it was just a lot of fun, man. That was my first time, and being from a little small town in Cordova, you don't get to do that much.
Is that in South Carolina?
Cordova, South Carolina. Cordova, South Carolina. All right. So.
Now, y'all getting hyped for this week?
We trying. We got, like I said, last week was so hectic getting ready for the, this past Saturday's game. We got all this week coming up. We got coronation and stuff. And
yeah,
a lot of people going to be missing practice or whatnot. But we're going to try and hold it down. We got to hold. Okay.
Don't be skipping practice to come to coronation.
Thank you.
I'm going to be looking out on the stage if I see you out there.
Because we do have a game.
That's what's up.
We do have a game.
So y'all getting hyped, right?
Yeah, so we got a whole new show. We got to do a whole new show, a whole new break. I'm going to do everything. Can't tell you what it is.
Okay.
You know, it's kind of.
Thought I was going to get to do it on
Ram Talk. Can't let you know. But it's going to be totally different.
So you like working along with Mario, y'all?
Yeah, Mario, he's a cool person. He takes his time, what he does with working with me. You know, he's never really worked with nobody as far as teaching them drum major skills before. But, you know, he's been real patient. And luckily, I catch on kind of quick.
He's been a good role model, a good mentor for me. Now,
so.
You're hard on the band members in practice.
Mario, he's a disciplinarian. I discipline the band. But as far as I'm sort of like the mediator. I keep everything cool. I keep everything cool between the drum Mario and the band. And I mean, because you need that in the band. You can't have all people telling you what to do and being hard on you. You need that person to be the calm, mellow person and whatnot. So that's pretty much me.
So class is going all right with you?
Class is going good, man. I can't complain at all. Midterms were straight.
All right, we're about to take a short clip from one of the games. Show you Chris in action. Right, that was a short clip from one of the games, showing Chris in action, dancing, freaking, and all that stuff. I want to thank you for coming through, Chris.
No problem, Marissa.
Talking with us. I enjoyed you.
Enjoyed you, too.
I hope you all just show out on Saturday.
We are.
I mean, fortunately, I'll be sitting with the Queen, so I can't get nasty like I usually do at the game. So. But I'll be there.
We're going to hold it down for you.
That's what's up.
Hold it down for you.
All right, thank you. We're going to go to a short commercial.
Have you spent time reading and looking over the chapter?
I've tried to, but I just can't get focused.
You know what the problem is? You're not doing your night right unless you're watching the nightlight.
I want you to close your eyes.
You're not doing your night right.
You ain't doing your night right.
Not doing your night right unless you're watching the nightlight.
Come on this journey.
Watching the nightlight, you dig?
Goes down in the night.
Best journey.
Goes out in the light. Y'all can catch it all on the nightlight. Holla.
Welcome back to Ram Talk. You know, we're kicking off this week for homecoming, and the next guest that we have is Coach Turner for the WSSU football team, our Rams. Yo. All right, I want to start off asking, what's your position in the coaching staff?
I'm the offensive line coach.
Okay. So you working with the boys who trying to get his points on them?
Yes, I'm working with the big guys up front who try to protect the quarterback and open up holes for our running backs.
Okay. Now, did you enjoy the game on Saturday with BET?
It was a great enjoyment for me. It was a nationally televised game. Our guys were psyched up. They played well for four quarters. So as a coach, it made me very proud of our guys.
Yes. Now, the team's record this year, what is that?
5-3.
5-3. Now, will we be able to be in the CIAA championship?
There's a chance. We need Fayetteville State to lose their last two ball games. But we're going to go out and we're going to play our last two the best we can so we can finish 7-3.
Okay. Now, the boys hype for this.
Always. Homecoming is always a festive activity around campus. So our guys are naturally going to be psyched up. So we're just waiting for Saturday to come.
Now, also, I want to ask you, now, how do you feel about them not showing our schools on TV that much, you know, on BET, as they show the big schools, you know?
that's how it is sometimes. I think what we did, we put our best step forward on national TV. We came out and we played well. It was a nice crowd. The students were there. The band was playing all night. So I think what we did is we put our best foot forward so they will come back next year and the year after that, hopefully.
Okay. Now, what got you started coaching?
I just love the game of football. I played it when I was five, and it really never got out of my system.
So you started when you was five?
A little boy. And okay. The next best thing from playing is coaching, I thought, and I'm right on pace right now with
okay.
that.
Okay. And did you coach in college, or how
no.
did you start? Did you play football?
Well, I played at Hampton University. From Hampton, I played 1 year with the Arizona Cardinals, and from there, I went back, finished my degree at Hampton, and I started out coaching high school in my hometown, which is Richmond, Virginia.
Okay. Now, you stay here in Winston, did you move
yes.
from Hampton?
Moved from Hampton back to Richmond. That's where I had my first teaching job. And after that, I actually coached 1 year at Virginia State. And then I came here, so I moved everything. This is now home.
Now, is it stressful to get your game plans together before the game or that week of?
It's not very stressful. The biggest thing is just like I tell my guys as students, you have to manage your time. So what we do is we start on Sunday and we're breaking film down constantly throughout the week. So right at kickoff, a lot of times before kickoff, we actually know what's going on. And it's not a big stress on Saturday because we prepare throughout the week.
Now, how do you do the recruiting situation?
Oh, with our staff, like most staffs, what we do is we break the state of North Carolina down and we give each coach maybe 6 or 7 cities and you go to the high schools and you just move about.
Okay. Also, are the teams, well, the football team, are they on curfew like before game days or?
They have a curfew 6 days a week, and we monitor the curfew Monday through Friday. Saturday after the game, of course, that's their night off to have, okay. you know, let their hair down, kind of, sort of.
Let their hair down.
Yeah.
Now, have you coached at any other school, just Winston-Salem State?
Virginia State.
Virginia State.
Yes.
How did you like it up there?
It was a learning process. That was my first college coaching job. I'm thankful to be here. I was thankful to be there at the time, but, you know, I learned a lot at Virginia State, and I'm mm-hmm. constantly learning here. So
okay.
right now, it's a learning process.
Now, you hyped for this week?
Homecoming. Always. Homecoming, always. Yeah. It's a
That's
big deal.
Good. So we're going to celebrate after we win.
You know what?
John C. Smith, the mm-hmm. Bulls. So the boys, how are they ready to practice?
They're ready to go. I think this past week, they came out and they played a fine football game against
yeah.
North Carolina Central. So usually when you have that kind of performance, it rolls over to the next week. So
now, how do you like working along with Coach Blunt?
Coach Blunt, that's my homeboy. We're both from Richmond, Virginia. I met him when I was in high school. Actually, he was coaching here. He came into my high school to recruit me, but
okay.
you know, I had different plans at the time. But I have nothing but admiration and respect for Coach Blunt.
Okay. All right. Also, are you fat? You had a family name? Yeah, family.
I'm single.
Single. Whoa, he's single, lady,
single.
Come watching him at the football games, walking up and down sideline. That's what's up. So, I was like, can't think of anything else.
Okay.
I would just like to thank you.
Thanks for
coming
me.
In.
All right.
And,
thanks for
talking with us.
Thank
I
you.
Enjoyed talking with you, and I hope to see you on the football field where I'll be cheering y'all.
Thanks for having
All
me.
All right. Thank you.
All right.
Have you spent time reading and looking over the chapters?
I've tried to, but I just can't get focused.
You know what the problem is? You're not doing your night right unless you're watching the nightlight.
I want you to close
you're
your
not
eyes
doing
and
your
imagine
night
the most
right.
beautiful
you
place
You ain't doing
world.
Your night right.
Not doing your night right unless you watch into the nightlight.
Come on this journey.
Watching the nightlight, you dig.
Goes down in the night.
Best journey.
Goes out in the light. Y'all can catch it all on the nightlight. Holla.
Welcome back to Ram Talk. I'm your host, Marissa Chavis. And beside me, I have Holly Price, the sophomore class queen. How you doing, Holly?
Good, how are you?
All right, now, tell us where you're from.
I'm from Gibsonville, North Carolina, right between Greensboro and Burlington.
Okay.
Small town.
We're going to go with Burlington. So you were a freshman class queen last year.
Yes.
Now you're sophomore class queen.
Yes.
And how do you feel about, I'm sorry, was it easy running for that position since you already did it before?
No, actually, I think it was a little bit harder. Because a lot of times, you know, when people already hold a position 1 year, you're not sure if people want you back for another year. But like the first year, I had to, you know, give it my all, write a good speech, campaign, and just hope that I win everyone votes.
Was the competition hard for you?
The first year, I ran against 12 girls, so that was kind of hard. This year, I think it might have been 6, maybe 7. It was a tough competition. I mean, there were a lot of qualified young ladies, and it was really nice.
Now, You ready for Wednesday night coordination?
Yes.
You are?
Yes. Very excited.
Ooh, please come. Coordination, 7 o'clock Wednesday. Yes. You will be surprised.
Yes.
Yes. So, homecoming. You ready? You hype?
I'm hype. I'm ready for homecoming. Yes. My second homecoming here, so, yeah.
Okay. So, sophomore class, when you like being the queen, like, got any perks going along with it, you know?
I really enjoy it. It's an honor to represent my class of 06. Yeah.
Ooh.
So, yeah, 06. 06.
Sound like a long way.
We're going to get there, though.
Okay. So, you don't shout?
No, I have an older brother. I'm the baby.
So you used to bully around, push you around? Knock
Yeah, a little bit, but he takes care of me. Okay. We're really close.
Are you involved with any other activities, not only singing, sophomore class queen?
Yes, I'm a part of Mosaic Modeling Troupe.
How'd the call go?
Mosaic.
So you love being a part of Mosaic Modeling with them, you know?
Yes, it's very exciting. It's a lot of fun. Make sure you come out to the step show. The intermission is going to be really good. You're going to enjoy it.
Okay. So is it hard balancing your time schedule between sophomore class queen right now this week and also Mosaic practice?
Yes, I have a lot of practicing going on right now and trying to balance that time of going to coronation practice, Mosaic practice, getting ready for shows and everything. It's hard, but I mean, you got to do what you got to do if you want to be involved in a lot
of
stuff. You
got to be dedicated.
You got to be dedicated, of course.
Can't run for class queen if you're not dedicated. You will work. Don't get it twisted.
You'll work.
Really. So you enjoy being alongside of Mignon and the other queen on the court?
Yes, I love it. Mignon is a great role model. I love being with Marissa. She keeps us laughing.
All the time.
All the time, for real. Crystal is great. And Angel, it was really nice meeting her. She's a great person.
All right. Well, I want to thank you for coming to the show. And I'll see you tonight at practice.
Yes.
Coordination practice.
Bring those heels.
All right. Oh, heels. All right. Thank you, Holly. And thank you for joining in to this edition of Ram Talk. Hope you have a banging homecoming week. Come to the comedy show tonight, 8. Burning, draw on 24. Okay.